Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. And this is lecture number 2.3 in the Transportation Model. The topic for the discussion is Optimum Solution. So, in the earlier two lectures, we calculated the basic feasible solutions using northwest corner method, least cost method, and Weigel's approximation method. And in this lecture, we'll find the optimum solution for a transportation problem. And we compared the three methods, all the three methods: northwest corner method, least cost method, and the Weigel's approximation method. And we found that among the three methods, Weigel's approximation method, it gives the minimum transportation cost. So, to find the optimum solution, we start the basic solution with the Weigel's approximation method. So, the learning outcome to the lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the transportation model. And this is the flow chart for calculating or for finding the optimum solution for a transportation problem or transportation model. So, first we have to find the basic feasible solution using the Weigel's approximation method. So, because among the three methods, Weigel's approximation method will give the minimum transportation cost. So, we can start with any method, but the problem is the number of iterations will be less for optimum solution when you use Weigel's approximation method for the basic feasible solution. Then we have to check the number of allocations are equal to m plus n minus 1 and are independent. So, independent means they should not form a closed loop. M is the number of rows, n is the number of columns. So, m is the number of sources and n is the number of destinations. So, m plus n minus 1 is the number of allocations required. Then we have to check for optimality. So, there is a mathematical technique to check the optimality. And we have to do that at the end of the optimality test, there will be cell evaluation matrix. If the cell evaluation matrix does not have any negative value, then the condition is optimality condition is satisfied. And if it is yes, then the current basic feasible solution is optimum. So, if any one of the cell has the negative value in the cell evaluation matrix, then the optimality test is not clear. So, it is no, the optimality condition is not satisfied. So, then we have to iterate towards the optimum solution using the UV method. So, that is one mathematical technique developed for calculating the optimum solution in the transportation model. Then next we have to find out the next basic feasible solution. Once again we have to check for optimality. So, this loop will continue. So, starting with the Weigel's approximation method, check for number of allocations and check for optimality. And there are two conditions, either yes or no. Based on the condition, we have to proceed, we have to stop the iteration or we have to proceed to the next iteration. Now, we take one example, example 2.5, find the optimum solution for the transportation, optimum transportation cost for the transportation problem. And here we have three sources and three destinations. So, the source capacities are S1 equal to 14. S2 equal to 12 and S3 equal to 5, and the destination requirements are demands are D1 equal to 6, D2 equal to 10 and D3 equal to 15, and this is the cell matrix and the cost matrix of the transportation problem. Now, we have to solve the problem. First, we have to find the basic feasible solution using the Weigel's approximation method. So, before you take the Weigel's approximation method, we have to check for the balance of the problem. So, when the supply capacity, sum of the supply capacity, so 14 plus 12 is 26 plus 5, 31, and the total demand is 16, 10 plus 6, 16 plus 15 is 31. So, total supply is equal to total demand. So, it is a balanced type of problem. So, in the Weigel's approximation method, so we have to find out the row and the column. For every row and every column, we have to find out the difference between the lowest cost value. We take the first row, so the lowest cost value is 4, the next lowest value is 6, the difference equal to 2. We take the second row, the lowest value is 4, The next lowest value is 8, the difference is 4. And you take the third row, the lowest value is 1, the next lowest value is 2, the difference equal to 1. So the difference value is written here on the right side of the supply. And similarly for the column, for the first column, the lowest value is 1, the next lowest value is 4, the difference equal to 3. And for the second column, the lowest value is 2, the next lowest value is 8, the difference is 6. And the third column, the lowest value is 4, the next to lowest value is 6, and the difference is 2. So after writing all the differences column wise for the column and the row, now we have to find out the maximum value. So the maximum difference is 6. Now the 6 is entering. For the 6, the demand is 10. So for the second column, the demand is 10. And among the 3 cells in the second column, the lowest cost matrix cost value is C32 equal to 2, where the supply capacity is 5. You exhaust all the supply capacity. We set the X32 equal to 5 and the demand is reduced to 5 now. Now next to the value, next cost is C12 equal to 8. Next lowest value is C12 equal to 8. We fix X12 equal to 5 and this is and the remaining balance here is 9. Now the next highest value is 4. Next highest value is 4, where the supply second row, where the supply capacity is 12. Among the 3 cells here horizontally, the C21 equal to 4 is the lowest value, where the demand is 6. So demand is 6, we set all the demand here, X21 equal to 6, and out of 12, the balance is 6, and this balance is set here. Next lowest value is C23 equal to 8. And we fix X23 equal to 6 and the 12 is exhausted. So here after reducing this will become 9 and this 12 is completely exhausted. Now the next lowest value is 2. So here this is already allotted. So we have only this lowest cell and here the lowest cell 4X, C13 equal to 4. Now the demand is 9 and the supply capacity is 9. It is set here. Then 9 is satisfied and completely it is complete. It is the table is my allotment is completed. Then we calculate the overall transportation cost. So here 5 plus 9 14 and here 6 plus 6 equal to 12 and it is 5 here and vertically here it is 6. 5 plus 5 equal to 10 and demand 9 plus 6 equal to 15. Now we calculate the overall transportation cost C12X12 plus C13X13 plus C21X21 plus C23X23 plus C32X32 and we substitute the numerical values. It becomes 8 into 5 plus 4 into 9 plus 4 into 8 4 into 6 plus 8 into 6 plus 2 into 5 equal to rupees 158. Now the number of allocations, second step, we have to check the number of allocations equal to m plus n minus 1 equal to 3 plus 3 minus 1 equal to 5. So there are 5 allocations. So we have 5 allocations here. All the 5 allocations are independent. Now that means not forming the loop. So it is not forming the loop. Closed loop is not formed. The allotments are independent. Now we have to check for the optimality using the UV method. So for optimality, you have to write the designate the row as U and column as V. So U1, U2, U3, V1, V2, V3. Write the cost matrix of allotted cell. So the allotted cell, so here see X12, X13, X21, X23, and X32, they are the allotted cell, and we have to write the cost matrix of the allotted cells. Now we designate, we take V1 equal to 0, we fix V1 equal to 0. And we calculate all the other values. For V1 equal to 0, and this is sum of U2 plus V1 equal to 4, so U2 becomes 4. When U2 becomes 4, so here I have 8. So here I have 8. Now this U2 plus V3 equal to 8, so V3 become 4. When V3 become 4, U1 equal to 0, so this condition is satisfied. So this becomes 4. Now we calculated. So they now look at here, U1 equal to, V1 equal to 0, U1 equal to 0 and V2 equal to 8. So initially we take fix V1 equal to 0, we calculate all the other values, U3 becomes minus 6. So V1 equal to 0, u3 actually you take this condition v2 equal to 8 and sum of u3 plus v2 equal to 2. So u3 equal to minus 6. So minus 6 plus 8 equal to 2. Now we calculate. So this the yellow color line, yellow color cells are unallotted cells. So white color cells are allotted cells. We know we have the value only in the allotted cells. Now using the u1, u2, u3, v1, v2, v3. Now we calculate the values of the unallotted cells. So here it becomes 0 and here it is 12. It is 6 minus 6 plus 0 equal to minus 6 and here it is minus 2. Now we have to subtract the values of unallotted cell from the original cost matrix. So original cost matrix it is given here. So this is the original cost matrix. So unallotted cell. So from the value of unallotted cell is subtracted from the original cost matrix. So here look at here 6 minus 0, 9 minus 12, 1 minus of minus 6, so 1 plus 6. 6 minus of minus 2 equal to 6 plus 2. Now this is subtract unallotted cell value from the original cost matrix and this is called as cell evaluation matrix. Now in the cell evaluation matrix there are 4 cells and we have 1 negative value. So the cell x22 has a negative cell value, then the basic feasible solution is not optimum. And this is the cell evaluation matrix. Using the UV method we calculate the cell evaluation matrix where we have 1 negative value. So the value, the basic feasible solution is not optimum. Now we have to iterate towards the optimum solution or the next basic feasible solution. So we calculate the second basic feasible solution. So we write the first basic feasible solution. So this is the original first calculated basic feasible solution and these are all the 5 cells where we have allotment. Now this is the again repeat the table again. Mark the cell in which new allocation is to be made. That means cell with negative value in the cell evaluation matrix. So this is the cell we require the allocation. This is the cell we have the negative value and we put a tick mark here. Now starting from the marked cell, form a closed loop with the corner of the loop falls in the allotted cell. So this is the cell we have to start from here. So we have to draw the vertical line. This is the allotted cell, horizontal line. This is the allotted cell, then vertical again, vertical downward. This is the allotted cell and form the closed loop. So this is the closed loop. So starting from here, we go to the x12, then we move horizontally to x13 and we move vertically downward to the x23 and close the loop. So here we have to make the allocation. So and we have to see that allot the new marked cell and balance horizontally and vertically. So I subtract 5 here, allot 5 here. So I make plus 5 here and minus 5 here, vertically it is balanced. Now here minus 5 and horizontally I put plus 5 here, so it is horizontally satisfied. And here it is plus 5 and I have to put minus 5 here, so vertically satisfied. Then here already plus 5 and this is minus 5, again horizontally satisfied. So we have to form the closed loop. The corner of the closed loop should fall on the allotted cell and we have to vertically balance, horizontally balance. So this is the new allotment. So the new allotment it goes like this. So instead of x12, now it is shifted to x22. Now this is the new allotment. So this is 9 plus 5 equal to 14, x13 equal to 14. There is no change here, x21 equal to 6 and here x22 equal to 5 and x23 equal to 6 minus 5 equal to 1 and there is no change in the x32. This is the second basic feasible solution. Now we second feasible solution and we calculate the transportation cost. Again 4 into 14 plus 4 into 6 plus 9 into 5 plus 8 into 1 plus 2 into 5, this becomes rupees 143. And this is the second feasible solution and once again we have to check for optimality. So for checking the optimality, once again we write the cell evaluation original cost matrix of the allotted cell. So these are all the original cost values of the allotted cells. So designate the row as a U and the column as a V, write the cost matrix of the allotted cell and we make V1 equal to 0 here. And when V1 equal to 0, this becomes V3 equal to 4, 0, here it is become 4, U2 equal to 4. So 0 plus 4 equal to 4, and this is 8. 4 plus 4 equal to 8, and when this is 8, when this is 4, and this is again this 4. So u1 equal to 0, and this u3 equal to minus 3, and these are all the values given here, and we calculate the uv value for the unallotted cells. So 0, 5, minus 3, and 1. Now, the cell evaluation matrix, subtract the values of the unallotted cells from the original cost matrix. So, 6 minus 0, 8 minus 5, 1 minus 3, 1 plus 3, and 6 minus 1. So, the values are 6, 3, 4, 5. This is the cell evaluation matrix, does not possess any negative value. So, the solution is optimum. So, the second feasible solution is optimum, and the cost is 143. Transportation cost is 143. So, we stop here. So, we continue in the next lecture another problem on the optimum. We take another example for finding the optimum solution in the transportation model. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You can find the operation research book. You can refer to the book for additional information, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments. You can contact me through mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. In next lecture, we'll continue with another example for optimization of the transportation problem.